This whole question reminded me of the whole process of decluttering, which I know a lot of people are doing, including my sister, who keeps sending me pictures of things that she finds from a long time ago. One of them she sent this week was an email I sent her, a printed out email from 2007 that had this reading on it that is so appropriate for our times. I wanted to share it with you. So as we declutter physically and emotionally, we might actually run into this contagion, and it's called inner peace. The title is Symptoms of Inner Peace, and it's by a registered nurse, Saskia Davis. She says, be on the lookout for symptoms of inner peace. The heart of a great many already have been exposed. And it is possible that people everywhere could come down with it in epidemic proportions. This could pose a serious threat to what up to now has been a fairly stable condition of conflict in the world. Here are the signs and symptoms of inner peace. A tendency to think and act spontaneously rather than on fears based on past experiences. An unmistakable ability to enjoy each moment. A loss of interest in judging other people. A loss of interest in judging yourself. A loss of interest in interpreting the actions of others. A loss of interest in conflict. A loss of ability to worry. Frequent overwhelming episodes of appreciation. Contented feelings of connectedness with others and with nature. Frequent attacks of smiling. An increasing tendency to let things happen rather than to make them happen. An increased susceptibility to love extended by others, and the uncontrollable urge to extend it. I hope we all catch this. The warning is, if you have some of the above symptoms, be advised that your condition of inner peace may be too far advanced to be curable. If you are exposed to anyone exhibiting any of these symptoms, remain exposed only at your own risk. So just a little fun for you there on these symptoms of inner peace that maybe many of us are running into. I hope so.